It's going to be the Megazord of kerfuffles. And penetrate my afternoon with their unpleasantness.
That wasn't that bad. Whoop!
At least all that embarrassing part wasn't on camera, so. Welcome back to Candy Adventures. I'm Chris.
I'm Elizabeth.
And we don't live in this truck camper anymore. Deception, bait and switch. We had originally planned, and as we've discussed with everybody that watches, we were going to travel the USA and explore the USA and be living out of this thing.
Unfortunately, we had about 4 family kerfuffles pop up in the first 2 months that we were back.
Yep, as soon as we landed back here on mainland USA, the universe punched old Papa here right into the old zipper over and over again. So our plans have been completely derailed, and we're still in North Carolina.
So, since we're here, I just begged big old Papa over here for a dirt bike.
Channel's not dead, but there has been some massive things, and we bought this 2004 Suzuki DRZ125 with the big wheels.
And this is because we had to leave my first dirt bike, the KX100, back in Guam. We couldn't ship everything, so we left that.
Our goal is to, we still have this truck camper, and we still want to get back out west, is to take the motorcycles, because I have a CRF300L, and she has this, and maybe at some point she'll have a street legal dual sport, so we can head out west and maybe do some backcountry discovery routes, maybe beat up around Utah and California or Colorado, somewhere big out west, and really ride some fun stuff and do some camping. So today we're going to head up into the mountains here of beautiful western North Carolina. It's super overcast, and we have the goal of seeing if we can ride up into the mountains and ride into the clouds. I might be pushing it a little bit too much because it's going to get very slippery and rocky, but hopefully we can. So let's get this loaded up onto our Xterra, which if you've been around the channel for a while, this thing's been waiting on us for 3 years in Stateside USA and family members' driveways.
Yeah, this Xterra was in like our first 5 videos, and then we
did Madonna Pass in the winter, you know, waist deep snow. We beat it up in the sand. It's touched both oceans, Atlantic and Pacific, on the sand and the beach.
Yeah.
Now it's used to drive around this little dirt bike so we can take it up onto a big piece of property and teach her how to ride a dirt bike.
So let's go, fam.
We've made it up here. This is about 15-20 minutes away from where we live, and this is a big piece of private property that we have been afforded the privilege of using as long as we do some maintenance up here. So for the last couple months in between our family emergencies, we've been coming up here and we've been cleaning some roads off. And bush hogging, running some tractors, reseeding some grass. And it's an incredible privilege that we do have, and hopefully maybe the people who own this land would let us buy a little piece and put our truck camper on it. So that would be super awesome. I'll be on this Honda Rancher over here, this old Honda four-wheeler, and she'll be on this old Suzuki, and she's gonna learn how to ride a clutch today or die trying.
Literally die trying. We're going up a pretty steep mountain, so.
All right, so I'm going to be coach cameraman today.
Also, this is completely irrelevant to learning to ride the dirt bike, but this is officially the coldest day that we've experienced in 3 years. It's 56 degrees, and Guam was almost always 85 degrees, so it's gotten cold here real quick.
And that little boonie dog right there has never experienced winter in her whole entire life. All right, so she's going to be leading the way for us, and hopefully it's not too slippery and rocky and rooty for her to get up here, and we can hopefully ride up into the clouds or at least get a nice view today. Nobody got hurt, and before all of you, please, before all, every single one of you safety Nazis, get in the comment section.
About a helmet.
Like every time you see me not wearing a seatbelt at the boat ramp or not wearing
or
a helmet.
Life jacket. Yeah.
Comment taken. You
we
don't
know.
Have to put it. You
we
don't have to put it.
We understand the associated risks and how it's probably really dumb to not have the seatbelt, the life vest, or the helmet.
Yes.
We know.
We get it.
Oh no. This kickstart gets stuck. Okie dokie. It's in first. Put out the clutch. So I've been practicing, but it's been on a grass field. This will be the first rocky, loose terrain, which is intimidating, but I'm up for the challenge.
All right, made it up through the first challenging section. That's the first crew test, but still pretty level.
And the good news is that I can flat foot this. Ooh, ooh, it's slippery. This region is so wet a lot of the time, even in the winter.
This part will look deceptive on the GoPro, but it's very steep, very slippery. Can we do the water crossing though? Oh, we did. Those are two things I was very worried about.
There's a little bump. I did it though. It was slippery in that covered part. It's still kind of wet. But it should be okay. We're fine. Now I gotta go up this hill.
Yeah, that was the first real challenge, and that was I was definitely didn't think that was gonna happen the first time, so I'm very excited about that. I thought I was gonna be catching the bike and picking it up or picking it up out of a ditch, but so that was really awesome.
So leaning forward a little bit.
Lean forward, going uphill, okay. Basically, and generally rule of thumb, lean forward uphill, lean backward downhill, okay. Trying to keep the machine from looping out or flipping over.
Okay. I'm kind of nervous. It's fine. I can do it. I'm ready. Ready?
Yep. At least all that embarrassing part wasn't on camera, so. This road is gonna be a goal. It's very steep. To bush hog this with a tractor, I have to back up it to keep the tractor from flipping over. Even ATVs, four-wheel drive ATVs feel a little tippy on this.
It's always hard to see like just how steep things are in camera. It's really hard to capture, but the incline for this is really like this. It's one of those hills that you dread walking up because you know about halfway up you're going to be super out of breath, even though you haven't run or anything. It's just the act of walking up something so steep. So I definitely would like something a little bit flatter while we're getting started.
So today we're going to go this way and go around and then come back down the hard part. All right, I'm going to run back down the hill and pick up that little teeny tiny four-wheeler down that very steep hill and then run back up here and continue cameramanning. I wouldn't have to do this except our camera operator, Shiho.
Shiho.
Hi, I'm Shiho.
She's in Japan.
Quit on us. She apparently moved to Japan to be with her family or something. I don't know what. All I know is that she was in Alaska, Guam, and now she's in Japan, so we assume Yakuza, but I'm not sure. But she apparently doesn't want to be our camera operator anymore, so now it's me sprinting up and down the hill, much like this dog right here is how I will be operating all day, just running back and forth running the camera because we don't have a camera operator. No big deal. Hill number three, success.
This little flat area is kind of what I've been practicing on, which is just a flat grassy field. I mean, it still has bumps and stuff, but it's a chance to get into second gear and kind of get more comfortable maneuvering and taking turns. So I just wanted to take a couple laps real quick and then we'll proceed upward in elevation.
And by field, what she means is about an eighth of an acre that we turned into a shooting range recently. Yeah. As you can see by the steel target set up here. So it's not really a field, it's more of a eighth of an acre. So it's a very small type place to learn how to ride a motorcycle. We're having a hard time finding somewhere where she can go straight and flat for more than, you know, 150 feet. It's kind of hard to do on the East Coast.
Oh my gosh, these water bars get very dippy. So this first section that we kind of went through was freshly cut just a few years ago. So there's briars everywhere all along the side of the roads. And that's what we've been clearing up for the past couple months. But still, there's, you can see some overhang, and I really don't want to brush up against it because those briars get stuck in your skin real nice and you get lots of cuts. So the second part that we're entering is old growth forest. So this old growth section, there's a lot of leaf litter and it rains a lot in this area, so I'm sure it's gonna be kind of slippery, which will be the different challenge for this section.
A little. Not for me, because I'm basically riding a couch. a big, slow, boring, but comfortable couch.
That's true. And you have a push start. You don't have to kick start on a little hill.
I do. Like a boss. Like a boss.
Oh no!
Are you in second gear?
No. I just wasn't giving it enough gas.
Alright, that's our first stall of the day.
Alright, I think I'm gonna maybe try to get in. Oh my god, that's slippery! I was about to say get into second, but I don't know. There we go! Alright.
Alright, we got big things happening. We're hitting second gear.
Oh yeah.
We've hit the old growth forest. We've conquered like three or four hills. We've only stalled one time.
That's pretty good.
And we have come, which is probably going to be the most challenging uphill section of the ride. So we're going to stop. Mona's going to get some water. I'm probably going to drink a little water out of that creek and prepared for maybe having to help her push this motorcycle
off
up this
hill.
Very steep section here.
So this section is a mix of like old growth, lots of leaf litter, and it has the big water bars, and it's pretty steep. So it's gonna be all three of the things together in one section.
It's gonna be the Megazord of kerfuffles, as they all come together at once and penetrate my afternoon with their unpleasantness.
It's the first time I've ever ridden this outside of the little tiny grass field, so it's fun. It's accomplishments regardless.
Super promising, still have a big trip out west to do some sort of dirt biking adventure on the map. You know, sometimes when you think, oh, I'd like to do something,
uh-huh,
and then you do that hobby for, let's say, 30 minutes, and you instantly realize, like, no,
oh,
I hate this.
Yeah.
I participated in some rock climbing one time, and I knew within one moment of being up on the rock.
That's not for you.
This is not my sport. And I pushed through it for the rest of the day. And that was 15 years ago, and I'll never go rock climbing again. So I'm glad that this is not her rock climbing.
Okay, let's get some water.
So if you've learned anything from this channel, you know not to take life advice from Candy Adventures. Take fishing advice, take outdoors advice. Now, because we've been working up here for 2 months, I know for a solid gold fact that there's nothing at the top of this mountain but woods. There is no construction, there is no houses.
Farmland.
There's no anything. It's just a covered over spring that dips in and out of the dirt. I've not gotten sick in my whole life from this particular creek. So do not just drink out of any creek and say, well, Candy Adventures did it. They must be geniuses. They almost have 3,000 subscribers. They must really know what the hell they're doing. They don't, but I will drink out of this creek. The trick is to get the sand out of it by digging a little hole. That's some good water. That water is probably only second to Aquafina. Aquafina makes a good product, and I support the Coca-Cola company wholly, and I don't think a big corporation would ever do anything to hurt you. They have your best interest in mind, and second only to Aquafina, this is the best water on planet Earth.
Yeah.
In all honesty, this is probably the best water on planet Earth, and it doesn't have any of that harmful fluoride that solidifies your pineal gland. So it's good for your pineal gland. And that might help us find Bigfoot out here.
Let's go, let's get it over with. Rip the Band-Aid off. I'm either gonna succeed or fail a little bit, but that's okay, because you learn from it. Ooh, it's so steep! Oh, I'm so intimidated.
All right, so we've had to switch cameras real quick because GoPro, their products, I love them and hate them at the same time. This camera has overheated its battery and shut down.
In 56 degree weather.
All right, so we're a quarter of the way up this hill. Let's see if we can, make it. I think I'm just gonna walk beside and coach and be here if it falls over and wants to start rolling down the hill.
Yeah, it'll be a good workout for him and heart attack for me. Okay.
Remember, foot on the pegs and lean forward.
Okay.
Also, don't do that.
More gas. Also, more gas.
More gas, more gas, more gas.
Okay.
Why are you holding the brakes still?
Because I'm worried about it going backwards.
So I sprinted all that.
Oh my god.
My legs are on fire. Oh my god.
I thought I was gonna lose it like four times.
Ooh, give me a second. Okay. That was well done on the riding.
Oh my gosh.
Oh boy. I know the camera, everybody always says, doesn't show steepness, but that's really steep.
I can't believe you just sprinted that. That is by far the steepest part we've gone up.
Ooh, that was rough. But the cool part is, because again, we don't have our camera operator, Shiho. I get to run back down the hill and do that again to go get the four-wheeler. All right, but we did it. That's this direction of the loop, that is by far the hardest section.
Yeah.
We start to get out of the canopy a little bit, out of the tree line just for a second, and hopefully we can get some cool views. So I'm gonna throw up and then go get the ATV and be right back.
Going, hopefully we can get out here and see some view and maybe get into these clouds that are up here.
Remember, keep your weight forward.
Okay.
You can try to stand up over the obstacles, that helps a lot.
I just worry because it's a little short.
The problem with these undersized bikes, they're good to learn on, but they're very hard to stand up on because you get hunched over. Kind of like a monkey consummating his relationship with a football. You're kind of all hunched over. So the next bike will definitely be a little bigger so she can stand easier.
It looks so awkward. It feels awkward.
It might be too small. All right.
That's pretty good.
Done the most challenging part. This is starting to feel very similar to my one of my last jobs in Guam. I was a ATV / side-by-side tour guide, hiking guide. But following people on an ATV and filming them is something I did for about 6 months.
There's pigs everywhere.
While we were in Guam, and this is starting to have flashbacks of running to get cameras and filming people and kind of a weird deja vu.
We have stopped right here just because the brush on the side of the road is really short and we've cut it down a little bit and you can finally see some elevation over here. I don't think we're going to touch the clouds today, but you can see that there's some other mountaintops just across the valley that are definitely in cloud cover.
Mona has a big belly full of bear poop now, so that's awesome. That happened because I wasn't being a good supervisor. Well, I don't supervise a damn dog anyway, but there's a lot of black bears up here, a lot of black bears in this area in general, and it's fun to see their tracks. Every time you come up here and we've been working on these roads, the next morning you'll come and there's bear tracks all over, and I love black bears. Haven't seen one. I was really hoping maybe we could get it on video, but Mona's for sure found some poop and has a big old belly full of it.
There's also coyotes and deer and little bobcats up here too. All sorts
maybe
of.
Maybe Bigfoot?
Well, definitely
Bigfoot. I come up here alone a lot and I put in headphones or earphones because I don't, you know, tractor's kind of loud and the bush hog's kind of loud. And I'll be bush hogging and I get this weird feeling all the time. And then the other day I was up here cutting some trees down, and the next day I came up to that same area and there was trees in the road. And they were not cut down trees, they were pushed down trees.
Ooh.
And you know, I'm not a big Bigfoot believer, but when you're up here by yourself and it's dark and you can't hear anything, you got your earphones in and you're all by yourself, and there's the road that you were just working on yesterday, and there's no people around, there's this property doesn't go anywhere, there's no roads, houses, anything like that, and there's pushed down trees across the road that you just opened up yesterday, it is creepy. So probably Bigfoot, probably most 100% bears.
Yeah.
75% Bigfoots up here, but maybe we'll get some on camera. If not, we're gonna keep riding.
Yeah, so the rest of this portion is just gonna be downhill, which is gonna be, for me, just the most nerve-wracking part.
The Black Diamond part is coming up next,
yeah.
So we'll wind around a little farther and then get to that. But I think it'll be okay. It rained a couple days ago, so it's not pure mud, it's just a little moist.
Yeah, if I can tackle that today, then I mean, this was a pretty big success. This is only my fourth time riding this dirt bike.
And a success, I only used the word moist once in a video today. Ah, damn it, that's twice. Anyway, let's keep riding.
Ooh. Oh, Lord. What? I don't like hitting those sideways. Okie dokie. The engine braking is helping a lot, just keeping it in first gear. I haven't been touching the gas at all. Oh god, okay. I forgot to stop for a second. My inner thighs were clenching this bike so hard.
Alright, this hill back here is going to be the moment of truth. Hopefully we can do this before the GoPro batteries run out and it absolutely just the sky opens up and starts pouring the rain on us, but I think she'll be fine. The ground's pretty tacky and she seems to be getting the hang of it pretty well, so fingers crossed.
When you don't want to. Woo! Okay. Oh my gosh, that was the most butt-clenching part. Woo! Okay. Alright, this isn't that bad. Ooh, this is a big water bar though. Oh, I don't like that. Yeah. Oh. Oh. Woo! I think even the even the four-wheeler slides down this. Oh my god, I just made down that. That was so butt-clenching. I was screaming, controlled sliding!
That's what it is. If you've never ridden a motorcycle, or especially a motorcycle off-road, there's a lot of playing with the friction point and
yeah.
When can I lock it up and applying the brake without locking it up. But sometimes you have to drag the rear end a little bit. And
okay, that wasn't that bad. I didn't fall.
No. It was super good, and we made it back to our original start point here, and nobody got hurt. And before all of you, please, before all, every single one of you safety Nazis, get in the comment section.
About a helmet.
Like every time you see me not wearing a seatbelt at the boat ramp or not wearing
or
a helmet.
Or life jacket. Yeah.
Comment taken. You
we
don't
know.
Have to put it. You
we
don't have to put it.
We understand the associated risks and how it's probably really dumb to not have the seatbelt, the life vest, or the helmet.
Yes.
We know.
We get it. Again, don't do the things we do. Don't get Giardia drinking out of your local creek, or please wear a helmet. Yes.
Yes.
We're not life examples here. So
yes.
We get it. I think that's a success. even though ammunition is really expensive right now, I think we're going to take a celebratory Glock 19 mag and shoot at some steel targets real quick, and we're out of here, and we'll see you guys next video.
Doing something
with the truck camper, the motorcycles, looking for Bigfoot. Not sure what yet, but thanks for sticking around. We'll see you guys hopefully next week.